what are our records in our life? What are we talking about here?
Well, let's talk about a great band from your homeland of Canada, where we are right now, Fucked Up. This has got to be my favorite of all the contemporary rock bands. This album would have been my choice for the best of 2011, probably. I love this album. Oh yes, I would choose it to be number one. At the same time, it's probably their most accessible album. It's their poppiest, their most melodic. It's a true pop punk classic. Sweet, Fucked Up, David Comes to Life. What a record. And they're Canadian. What a great play. What else we got? Speaking of punk music that's a little more on the adventurous side, how about Big Audio Dynamite? The Globe.
That was an interesting departure for sure.
For Mick Jones of The Clash, moving into more of a hip-hop vibe. He samples Should I Stay or Should I Go, which is a very funny move for him because, you know, he wrote that song anyway. Then he chopped it up, made a rap beat into it. He's got this funny English MC on it, spitting. So,
were you a big Clash fan before?
What punk doesn't love The Clash? I mean, they're one of the greatest, even if they might have been posers, potentially.
Did you become a fan as you were a younger lad? You get into Big Audio Dynamite, or were you into The Clash?
I got into Big Audio Dynamite a lot later on, from a cassette that I bought at a store not unlike this one back in America.
Do you listen to a lot of cassettes these days, too?
Yeah, we got a cassette player in the van, so that's a lot of... When it's my turn to pick the music, I often reach for the cassettes. They're fun. They're so tacky.
And really reasonable. I mean, you can buy great tapes.
Yeah, you can get one for like a dollar.
Yeah. And a good selection. There's millions out there.
They're out there, and people are looking to get rid of them all the time.
Right.
You can't hardly spin a 12-inch single like this in the car. So for me, that's not going to work.
Unless you're Keith Richards.
Right, he had the 45 machine in his car,
as I read
in that book.
Wasn't that great?
I can't help but imagine that it would skip a lot. Let's see what else we got in here. Speaking of Canada.
Here we go again.
Ontario's Neil Young with his album Live Rust with Crazy Horse. This is a great one because it captures the horse at the peak of their powers on their tour behind the Rust Never Sleeps album.
Those guys jammed. I mean, what's your, like, a lot of people say, oh, they were terrible musicians, but they had the chemistry, right?
They did. They had a certain magic, even if they didn't have the most finesse. But that's okay. That suits me just fine.
Like, Neil Young is, you could probably call him one of the godfathers of punk rock. Spiritually.
He definitely laid out a lot of the aesthetic parameters, for sure. As far as keeping it real, keeping it live, keeping it raw.
Oh, he's still playing, man. He's still rocking out.
He does, yeah. We just listened to his new album, Psychedelic Pill, in the van the other night. A lot of fun. This guy's the man. Where could he come from but Canada? Canada does it again, wow.
Yeah, Canada's got a good, it's not only Celine Dion and Nickelback, right?
Yeah, what else we got? Here's a great band from Brooklyn, New York, Parts and Labor, recently deceased band. They just broke up this year. I actually had the honor of DJing at their last ever show in Brooklyn in February of this year. But this is their album Receivers, which came out, I think, 2 years ago. They kind of have a Celtic melodic sensibility, and they've got a lot of cool keyboard tones, like glitchy electronics. They have got bagpipes sometimes, which I love. But yeah, this is a dope album.
I like the artwork on that one too.
It's lovely. It's futuristic.
It's a very futuristic band.
Well, they were a very futuristic band. All right, and last but not least, what list would be complete without the Velvet Underground, the greatest band of all time? We've got their self-titled third album here. This is them at their most chilled out, their most beautiful, the most kind of pristine and precious, as compared to like the White Lightweight Heat album, which came before, which was quite raucous, abrasive affair. And look at Smiling Lou on the cover here. He looks like he's having a blast.
I was going to ask you about that. Lou is actually, it's about half a smile, right? If you look at it closely, it's about half
a smirk.
But his bandmates don't look happy at all, because they're not.
You might not be happy either if you had to work with him.
Look at Mo. Mo is like glaring.
It's pretty all right. More than I can say for myself.
Wow. we'll see in 20 years or 30 years.
I don't know if Titus Andronicus will ever have the far-reaching influence of the Velvet Underground. If music be the food of love, play on. I think Shakespeare said that, maybe.
And so be
play on. Bon appetit. Rock and roll. Right. Well, geez, I gotta restock these. I got a show to do tonight. Let's go.